The big thing with this Candida auris is it's resistant to many different types of medications. Hi, everybody, and thank you for tuning in, and thank you for submitting all of your health questions. I will be doing videos based on those questions. I really appreciate it, and I've spent some time researching some of the questions, which were really, really good questions that everybody submits. I love to have everybody involved in the community to be able to answer these questions. We are dealing with a lot of different health concerns these days, so I'll just jump right in. What is going on with this new threat, this Candida auris, that has been in the news recently and that has been claiming lives, and more people are getting infected, and this is spreading. So what exactly is Candida auris, which is spelled A-U-R-I-S? I've been talking about this for a long time, actually. Candida auris was originally isolated in 2009, and it is a form of yeast or fungus that can cross into the bloodstream and cause death, actually. So you may be seeing it throughout the newspapers these days, throughout the news, and what we are dealing with now is considered an outbreak. Many people are asking what to do about this, what it is. It's basically causing panic across the globe right now. The big thing with this Candida auris is it's resistant to many different types of medications. And not only is Candida auris a superbug, let's say, but many other superbugs are starting to pop up now. We're starting to see bacteria that's resistant to medications, which just comes back into the theory that when you have man-made science and you have man-made pharmaceutical drugs, nature is always going to win in the end. Now, there's people out there that I've researched that have been on YouTube that are saying that Candida auris was actually man-made in some labs. It might be a bioweapon. It's nobody really knows exactly how it came to be with many other of these superbugs, such as avian flu, the SARS, and all these strange bugs that are popping up everywhere that no one can really isolate as to the root cause. But it doesn't really matter if you have really good natural things in your medicine cabinet. So yeast is actually a fungus, and so is mold. A lot of people don't know that. And at least 150 species of yeasts are known as Candida. It's something you might have heard of, Candida albicans, which has been around for a long time, and many people have systemic yeast infections, which is something that I've been really trying to work with people on and educate people on, because I think it's a lot bigger health concern than most people want to believe, and doctors are just not testing to see if you have mold, if you have yeast, if you have, well, any type of fungus, basically. One of the things that we have been looking at is how does Candida work in the body and how does it affect the body negatively? And most Candida strains will release up to or a variation of 80 different toxins into the body. And when I say toxins, toxins are chemicals or byproducts that do harm to your system. You know, usually microorganisms can secrete when they go to the bathroom, when they produce different compounds and excrete those compounds through their cellular matrix. And those things can be acid forming and extremely toxic to your body. And what they do is they just suck energy from your body because it weakens your defenses. And I've always talked about we all have a self-healing mechanism. You know, our body has the ability to heal itself. And what suppresses our body's self-healing mechanism can be a multitude of factors. Chemicals and toxins from the air, the food, the water, and the microbes we have in our system. But candida, a lot of times, is located in the gut, or can enter the bloodstream through catheters or other things like that. And it can also cause gut damage and cause little holes in the gut to where we leak these chemicals and these toxins through. Now, most recently, the Candida auris has been found in nursing homes and has been found in hospitals. Over 500 cases have been identified in the United States, and the Center of Disease Control and Prevention has stated that most of these have happened around New York, New Jersey, and Illinois. So if you do live in those areas, take extra caution to do some things that keep your immune system strong and keep your body healthy. Talking about the symptoms of Candida auris, mostly or typically people are suffering from fever and chills. So if you have fever, if you start coming down with chills, many different things cause fever and chills. The common cold being one of them, influenza. But just be on the lookout, and if you have visited a hospital, if you visited somebody in a hospital, if you have those symptoms, you might want to just be cautious. But the biggest thing with C. auris or Candida auris is the medications that are being used, basically the lack of medications being used to possibly treat this. But if you are showing signs, you might want to go in, you might want to get tested. And then the big thing, because there are no current medications and because this C. auris infection is resistant to antifungal medications, what I would recommend is working on your self-healing mechanism, especially if you've been diagnosed. According to the CDC, they're saying nearly half of people who contract Candida auris die within 90 days. That's not good. And this is something that needs to be shared more. This is kind of a warning signal. I'm not worried about it because I know how to protect my body against any type of these super bugs, which they're calling them, which are coming out and can possibly cause death in a short period of time. What I always tell people to do is just keep your immune system strong by choosing the right types of foods to eat, eating more healthy, incorporating intermittent fasting, getting lots of rest. One of the best things you can do to keep your immune system strong is sleep. It keeps your stress levels down. Stress is another big thing that's going to all of the time that you're in a state of stress, your immune system is in a state of stress. When you're in a sympathetic mode, your immune system has to focus on addressing the stress at the particular time that you're under or the stressors that you're under. So try to reduce stress. One of the easiest ways to reactivate your immune system, keep your immune system strong. And one of the ways it's been proven to reduce stress is taking 9 deep breaths or getting into a meditative state, doing something that relieves stress, watching something funny, laughing, taking your mind away from that. Keep your toxin intake low as well, and that means drink clean water. As a matter of fact, if you want to just improve your immune system, make sure that you avoid any type of chemical-laden, artificial sweeteners, beverages, alcohol, anything that can reduce your immune system, energy drinks, any type of beverage. Just basically reduce those beverages and start drinking nothing but pure, clean water. Or just distilled water. And I like to add a little organic apple cider vinegar into that distilled water. And that organic apple cider vinegar, the raw apple cider vinegar, helps energize that distilled water, but it also provides you the minerals and the enzymes and all the immune stimulating components to help kind of keep your immune system strong. Another thing I would recommend would be to avoid sugar. You know, sugar feeds fungus. Cut down on your sugar or avoid it altogether. Use natural replacements like monk fruit, long jack, stevia, organic stevia, things like that. And that way you are taking the food away from the organisms that need to survive and what they like to eat to survive. And last but not least, stay away from hospitals. I mean, I don't want you to think that, you know, you can't go visit your loved ones or anything like that. But especially if you're in those areas and you're looking at the CDC website to kind of track where the spread of this Candida auris is, just stay away from those areas as much as you can until this gets under control. So I hope that gave you enough information. If there's anything I'm missing on that, please feel free to comment and ask any additional questions. And I'll be happy to steer you in the right direction, whether it's, you know, are there any products I can take, or is there anything else I can do to enhance my immune system, or I need help with cleansing the body or healing the gut. You know, one of the best ways to always keep your immune system in maximum capacity is to keep your gut healthy. So if anyone needs any additional information on that, I'd be happy to answer it.